Dear Pen Pals, my name is Irvin Bryant. I write this letter to you from the Kingdom of Eswatini, where I serve as a volunteer in the United States Peace Corps. I plan to write and upload something about my service at least monthly, hence the name Epistolic Irv. These are made in an effort to keep concerned parties updated and to work toward the Peace Corps' third of three organization-wide goals. And in doing so, I must preface with the following. Disclaim? I don't know. So without further delay, the Peace Corps is not an adventure. Many have said so, but I couldn't disagree more. Allow me to illustrate my point with some adventurers that you may know. Indiana Jones, T.E. Lawrence, Nathan Drake, Tintin, Steve Zissou, maybe even a Walter Mitty. Yeah, when I look at my assignment, my training, my leaders, when I look in the mirror, I gotta say, you're not that guy. You are not Indiana Jones. Your journey is not a swashbuckling heroic adventure. You are not a leading scholar with inexplicable whip skills who is also a deadshot and a formidable fist fighter. You are an intellectual, a nerd who is fond of artifacts, maps, lecture halls, and artifacts like the kind that dress the sets of Professor Jones's scenes. You are not the one capable and courageous Caucasian American amongst a crowd of morally, physically, or mentally weaker brown people. You will be a guest in a foreign land, reliant on the generous aid of like-minded companions who are native to the country. You may be on a mission to promote peace and friendship, but you will not save the world, let alone a damsel in distress. You are not T.E. Lawrence. You do not like to play with fire, metaphorically nor literally. You are not on a mission to alter the politics of other nations. You will, stitch by stitch, find yourself hemmed into the fabric of what is, for now, a totally foreign country. You will not lose yourself in this process, believing the fictions, the hype, whether told by you or your host community. You are not Tintin. You are not an intrepid young Belgian reporter or journalist. You are going to Africa, the long-lost motherland, the Kingdom of Eswatini, like all the fantasies of Zamunda and Wakanda realized even before they were conceived. So remember Peace Corps' third goal, to tell the subalternist narratives of Swazi life with the requisite respect and reverence. These are not your stories, not your scoop, not your viral moment, not your silhouetted caricatures. This is a land of kings, queen mothers, chiefs, matriarchs, politicians, priests, doctors, teachers, farmers, families, each bearing the image of God. You are not Nathan Drake. You are not on a mission to unearth some foreign wealth that natives are inexplicably incapable of reaping for themselves. You do not have inhuman grip strength, nor Peter Parker-esque climbing abilities. You come to this kingdom offering peace and friendship to host country nationals, and not an endless volley of bullets aimed at hundreds of nameless brown non-player characters. However, you will explore some sublime scenic landscapes, so that's nice. You are not Steve Zissou. You are neither white nor middle-aged, nor are you a professional explorer. You are a Peace Corps volunteer, trained to aid people in reducing HIV/AIDS prevalence, trained in preparing the youth for the workforce and engaging the community in sustainable problem solving. You are not propagating nor continuing any form of master narrative of Westerners venturing into an exotic global South while much more talented black people wordlessly set the tone in the background. You won't risk life nor limb in fits of vainglorious machismo. You won't turn this expedition for the good of all into a personal crusade. You will unwittingly commit cultural transgressions, need to rely on more capable teammates, and you probably won't achieve your initial goal. You are not Walter Mitty. Again, you're not a middle-aged white guy. You did work a boring, dead-end job in which you endured the disrespect of impeccably groomed professionals on a regular basis. You did not let circumstance kill your calling. You did daydream, escape, fantasize, envision, ruminate about what your life would be like when enabled to answer that calling. But you will not depart to escape the hardship of the daily grind. You will work harder than you ever have before, not for a paycheck, stock options, nor commission. You will work for your community, for your neighbor. This is not a farewell to arms, but an open-hearted embrace of the wretched of the earth, the least of these. For the above reasons and more, I repeat, you are not Indiana Jones. These videos are not directed by Steven Spielberg, and this is not a Lucasfilm channel. You're not that guy.
Trust me, you're not that guy.
Let me know if you feel it, man, cause everything I'm not made me everything I am.